Federal Health Minister Greg Hunt joins us now. Thank you for your time, Minister. 24 hours ago, the advice was that AstraZeneca was safe despite cases of the blood clots already recorded. Why the change of mind?
So we've had evidence from Europe, which has been considered by the Australian Technical Advisory Group on Immunisation, the medical experts. And what they've determined is that even though there are very rare cases in under 50s, that it's nevertheless important to provide the advice that the preferred vaccine for under 50s would be Pfizer, and we've procured an extra 20 million units. But for over 50s, this is a safe, effective vaccine that's still recommended. And we've just seen in the last 24 hours over 81,000 vaccinations, a record level. So it's about getting Australians vaccinated, but doing it safely. And right through the pandemic, we've followed the medical advice and we've reacted quickly to the evidence. And that's what's allowed us to be one of the safest countries in the world.
We've obviously been relying heavily on AstraZeneca to meet our vaccine targets. Is that target now in jeopardy, particularly when the Pfizer isn't coming on until the end of the year?
So we have 20 million Pfizer units which are already coming on, and they will grow as the year goes on. There's an additional 20 million which takes it to 40, which we've now procured. And the current rollout for the over 70s and over 80s is going on unchanged. The next rollout for the over 50s and over 60s will go on unchanged. And then as we move to the under 50s, that's the time when the additional Pfizer supplies, which we already had and which we've now procured, will really come into their own. So we won't make a prediction just yet because we want to be very careful in modelling the implications of this. But right now, the basic programs of 1B for the over 70s and 80s and then 2A for the over 50s and 60s will continue with AstraZeneca. And I think Australians should have real confidence that the medical advice that's protected us through the pandemic is exactly what we're following here. And that says it's safe, it's effective, it will save lives and protect lives.
When you talk about the confidence in the vaccine rollout, here in Victoria, for example, this afternoon, there have been a number of GP clinics that have stopped administering vaccines, even to those over 50 who are eligible. Is that acceptable?
Well, it's a matter for each general practice, in our discussions with the AMA and the College of GPs, they've been deeply, fundamentally supportive of the program, of the medical advice, of the participation. There may be certain practices where they're looking at their consent forms, they're getting them right, but all of our advice and the advice of the AMA and the College of GPs on top of the medical expert panel is that this is safe and this is effective and it will save lives and protect lives. Over 20 million doses have been administered in the United Kingdom. And what we're doing is following the medical evidence from around the world, which has led to the medical advice that for those that are under 50, there is a higher rate, albeit still very, very rare, of possible complication. And that's why for under 50s, now the Pfizer is the recommended, but there's no prohibition on the AstraZeneca. And then for the over 50s, AstraZeneca remains the principal vaccine that is recommended and in place. And it's something I've taken myself and Professor Brendan Murphy has taken. And it is all about saving lives and protecting lives and vaccinating the nation.
Can you understand the confusion amongst people and perhaps the lack of faith now in the vaccine rollout, particularly with the situation in Victoria last year?
Well, I think what's very important is that we do follow the medical advice, and we've moved very, very quickly. Literally within 15 minutes of receiving the final medical advice, the Prime Minister and myself, the Chief Medical Officer, and Brendan Murphy, who's the head of the Vaccines Task Force, stood together to provide that advice to the nation. And by being able to have clear advice, which says, if you're over 50, please proceed, we know that these are the very people, the very groups that have helped keep Australia safe, It explains why on a day when there were 800,000 cases worldwide and zero cases in Australia of community transmission, we've been able to do these things because we've followed that advice. And that advice is please be vaccinated with the AstraZeneca vaccine if you are over 50, and please be vaccinated with the Pfizer vaccine when your time comes if you are under 50.
And just finally, what will actually happen to the millions of locally made AstraZeneca doses, given that so much of the population is now restricted from having it?
So we still have a lot more to produce to ensure that all of the over 50s have access to this, and we'll review with CSL our needs and our requirements, but also our ability to support other countries. And they've been an amazing partner. It was impossible that we would scale up and have these vaccines, and yet it's been done. It's given Australia enormous supply security. It won't be applied as widely as we had initially thought, but it will still be applied for all of those Australians over 50 who seek it. And that means that if we can vaccinate people early, we can protect as many of the vulnerable Australians as possible, as early as possible.
Health Minister Greg Hunt, thanks so much for your time this afternoon.
Thanks very much.